apprenticeship is done.
Do some killing.
Ammo, nice.
You could be an asset.
Let's go.
So we'll be getting underway on our travel here before doing the giveaways for the clan. About 8 minutes, it looks like.
Yeah.
Got a lot of dancing going on here. Definitely need more dance animations. Here we can see a nice overview of all the people gathered here for the walk. That's cool. We're getting the Eve model instead of everybody showing up as they're supposed to. Get a few people here.
Bye-bye.
Okay, it's 5:59. In just a minute here, we'll be starting up the walk. First leg.
Get him.
Roll out.
We're walking through the old part of the map now. The starting area. Back before DLC 5 changed everything. Used to be fun to hang out all over the different spots of the map. Running into different kinds of events which are localized. The big problem was with that change and the quote-unquote ego scaling. You pretty much were messing up or screwing with anybody of the lower ranks by just being in the area. And sometimes that was fun. It was almost like a way of trolling beyond being one of those people who kept the Titan trucks forever set up. But you really just don't want to do it to people all the time, just showing up when they're trying to complete a mission and making it next to impossible for them. I guess for tomorrow I'll try to figure out getting the TeamSpeak running. Hey, look at that pop-up notification of what we're doing. Tomorrow I'll try to get the TeamSpeak set up so that we could have some more commentary while this is running. The event will be happening again tomorrow. Same time. Same bat channel.
Decoy is out.
Pass them forward.
Passing the radio station now. This is one of the more irritating follow-up contract events, mostly because it's timed. Most of the repurposed missions work pretty well, but the ones where they take a certain amount of time before it moves to the next stage, they can be a little bit irritating to do, particularly when they show up every week. Someone using the giant pumpkin launcher. Now the crowds thinned out. We're starting to get to see all the player outfits. One of the limitations in the game is that the handles for the memory are restricted mostly by what can be done on the consoles, and the Xbox 360 and PS3 versions having much less memory, PS3 in particular. There is a slider on the PC version which lets us see more, but certainly not the kind of crowd we're having here for this Cronus Defiance 4th anniversary celebration. And now we see some lag.
can't touch me!
Now leaving the starting area, generally this is not a spot that you interact with during the game once you finish the major story, but it is a nice little spot. I wish they had more of these little developed areas like over here on the right. Coming up on the first stop here, it looks like everyone wants to break out the rocket launchers. Get a little bit of explosion going on here. Thank you. And we're on the move again. Here's our clan founder, Altrus, using the pumpkin gun to lead the way.
coming fast!
A lot of people using swords for running, so I think I'll give that a shot for the next leg. That's edition one, why not a cinnamon stick? Originally, all this stuff going on here with the plague was event-based. Now it's become permanent, which means no one wants to hang out here because you don't want to hear all the mumbling and gurgling and complaining constantly.
Please tell me, how soon after you arrived to Paradise did you notice?
what the cat dragged in.
We are only going to contain this disease for a brief time. We need to find a cure. Did you have any recent contact with a human or erratic?
Hostile eliminated. If this makes it to Manhattan, the Republic would be in real trouble.
Okay, we're gonna get ready to start the next leg. For the many, many people out there or watching this after I've uploaded it to my YouTube channel, Defiance is not like a lot of other MMOs. It's probably not like any other MMO. If you approach the game as a single player sandbox that just happens to support more than the standard four simultaneous co-op players, you get a better sense of what the game is. Defiance has a full 80-hour story. If you were to do all the side quests, otherwise it's about 20 hours. It's an open world game. It's very underpopulated compared to others to serve the fiction. However, what it gives you is a chance to play parts by yourself, parts of it with a group, parts of it with random people showing up where you are, as well as take part into events, particularly Arc Falls. Arc Falls being randomly occurring that something falls from the sky, you clear out waves of enemies, and then you get some loot. Then there are major Arc Falls, where a number of the smaller Arc Falls are beaten first, and then there's a larger boss character that everybody works to take out at the end. Your character can play the game completely solo, except for when you don't mean to, and other people show up where you are. But just as likely, you can join a clan, like here I am in Cronus, which has been an excellent clan on PC. And you can also group up with people up to four. There are vehicles where all four of you can travel together at the same time. You don't have to run everywhere like we're doing here for this Defiance 4th anniversary celebration. The main thing that's attractive about Defiance, and I guess is what made it not work as an MMO for many people, is that it's a quick pick-up-and-play third-person shooter. The actual shooting action is very well done, with some caveats I won't go into here that are related to changes that were made to the game back in 2014. But it's just a fun game to jump into, shoot some stuff in the face, maybe check out what's going on with other people, and then log off. You know, put in as much or as little time as you want. You can grind towards being the 6,000 ego you can see in the upper left-hand corner, which is the maximum ego level. But it really doesn't need to be done to enjoy the game. It's just fun to run around, particularly because of how well-designed a number of the enemies are. The enemies such as the raiders, the mutants, they have a personality. They make comments while they're being shot, while they're fighting. It's a lot of fun. Dark Matter in particular has some. Weapons have nano effects. You see this in other games, such as being able to set people on fire, electrocute them, etc. And the various enemies react to these being set on fire in sometimes very hilarious ways. And it just makes the shooting fun. You get into the game, you get as much as you want out of it, and then you log off and maybe you feel like playing it again. It reminds me most of the old arcade game days. When you'd go up to the arcade, you'd put your quarter into Pac-Man or Galaga and play it till you died, maybe play another game, but more than likely you'd give another game you hadn't seen before, another one of your favorites, a shot. That's what Defiance is all about. You like the shooting, you get in, you do as much of it as you want, and then you're done and you move on. So I guess in terms of attracting an audience, that made things much more difficult for Try-On Worlds, because being able to play like a traditional MMO and just hunker down for hours and hours at a time is just not going to work, because you can only do that same thing for so long. Unlike other open world games, if you were going to look at your Grand Theft Autos or your Saints Row's, there just aren't enough variety in the side missions. They don't have the same replayability and fun, because you don't have even though you have a vehicle here, there's no hijacking of vehicles. There's nothing the equivalent of a taxi mission or something like that that's going to send you careening around the map to take advantage of that. So it's more of a, you come across something, you do that. If you feel like doing that same thing again, you find another occurrence of it on the map. But it's much more about the chasing of the arc falls. And if that repetition doesn't work for you, you just can't play it for hours at a time. But I don't think that's a bad thing. There's nothing wrong with a game that gives you 30 minutes of a great time in a day, and then you play it again when you feel like it. Guess we'll switch up to a different sword here for the next leg. Oh man, I didn't realize I had three. And we're off again. It's going to be time to cross the bridge here shortly. My first time playing in a 1080p full screen in quite a while, since getting my 4K and ultra-wide monitors and the non-stop events in the game. I'm normally playing with multiple 1080p windowed versions of the game so I can have my characters at the same time. I'm running 12 patron accounts during this event. However, at least with Shadow Play, I don't have another option. I did not take the time needed to make sure I was set up for all the streaming options that were available. When the game was first released, it played a lot like Grand Theft Auto in terms of half the map was walled off from you. Right here, the area that we're approaching was protected by the monolith device, which happens to be a boss at the end of one of the major arc falls I mentioned earlier. And it prevented any single player from going across. Of course, if you made friends with somebody, you could use a fast travel option to skip past them. But in terms of just normal play, you could drive up to that area and just would be insta-killed. However, when they added things into the game, particularly missions that could be done, side missions, what they called season missions, that happened to exist on the other side of the map, they figured they would just open the whole thing up for the whole time. As you can see, it's also a mined bridge, and normally you're running ahead of the mines being activated, but instead, the other players are activating them and blowing me up now. Two clans were picked from each server. The game runs on PC, Xbox 360, and PlayStation 3. And there are two servers for each. The North American servers and the European servers. So for this fourth anniversary event in Defiance, they picked two clans on each of those combinations. So in this case, Cronus, which I'm in and doing this Twitch stream for, is doing this event here between 6 and 7 p.m. That will be followed by an event done by Chaos Crew. because Chaos Crew is going to do their event at 7 now instead of us going to the overpass, which is sort of the central area of the San Francisco portion of the map, we're going to be stopping at the fork instead. Here we are at the fork. It's going to be prize time here shortly.
Ready to roll.
close out this stream, I'm going to go ahead and buy one of the 100 plus 10 bit boxes and see if we get anything fun. Tomorrow will be the last day you can take advantage of those. They give out a lot of different kinds of things that are all at least purples or epic. So let's give that a shot now. Oh, it's like I got some packs I haven't bought before. Let's take a look at those packs here. Nothing particularly great.
CDS down.
Be it for today. The giveaway, that was a lot of fun running across here, seeing everybody out, celebrating 4 years of this game, which is going to continue to go on. I guess as long as some of us keep spending money, they'll keep the servers powered on. But if you just came across this by accident, you really should give it a shot if you like third-person shooting, because it really is done well, and there are some fun guns.
That's what I'm talking about. Let's go. Yeah!
How's it going, man?